This is the OTB Television Network, a service of Capital District Off-Track Betting.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to this week's edition of Horses and Courses from the Saratoga Backstretch adjacent to Clare Court. We have 18 races to bring you, including the opening days from Del Mar and Saratoga. But we kick it off down at Delaware Park for the first time since 1989. Runners are grade one, the mile and a quarter. Delaware Handicap, the champ is here, Royal Delta 2-5.
And they're off in the Delaware Handicap. It's a pretty good start for them all. Royal Delta between horses. Toward the inside, Summer Applause. She's all in toward the rail. Nobody really being urged in this first furlong, and Royal Delta and Mike Smith has a rather easy lead as they come by the finish line the first time. It's Royal Delta leading four across the track. She's all in, Summer Applause, and Why Not, and Centering will be dropping back to last. An easy first quarter for Royal Delta on the front end. Couldn't have written it any better. Opening quarter in 24 seconds flat. Royal Delta, Mike Smith will say, catch us if you can today. Leads it by 2.5 lengths. She's all in toward the inside, closer than usual, right alongside Summer Applause. Then a gap of 2.5 to end Why Not, and Centering will have to come from last as they make their way around the clubhouse turn. Smith opens up on Royal Delta. She opens up 7 lengths on the field. She's all in, and Summer Applause, her heads apart in second and third. A gap of 4 to end Why Not, and Centering continues the trail. Half went in 47-2. He let out a notch on her there. Royal Delta down the backstretch in front by 7 or 8. Summer Applause now solo second. She's all in racing third, and Why Not moves up alongside, and Centering trying to move from last, but they've all got Royal Delta to catch. She passes the half. The 6 furlongs goes in 1:11-2. She really poured it on that half mile. Royal Delta in front by 8 lengths. Summer Applause and Why Not alongside. 2 lengths further back to Centering, moving up on the outside, and she's all in. They've got 3/8 to go, and Royal Delta to catch. She's still winging it on the front end, leads it by still 8 lengths. And Why Not and Summer Applause are still battling in second and third, followed by Centering, and she's all in. They've got a quarter to go in the Delaware Handicap. The mile in 1:36-1, and it's all Royal Delta on the front end. She's still in command. 4 across the track, battling for second. And Why Not on the outside. She's all in, trying to come back for more, but it's Royal Delta and Mike Smith. Royal Delta, the defending champ, is back in her game today, and she's going to dominate in the Delaware Handicap. She's geared down in the final 16th. Royal Delta by 10. The champ is back. She's all in second, and Why Not third.
Mike Smith puts Royal Delta on the front, and in the third quarter of 23-4, just breaks this race wide open. She wins by 10 3/4 lengths, setting a new stakes record on that behalf. Returns $2.80 for Bill Mott. The last time the Delaware Handicap was a grade one, Nastique won back-to-back Delaware Handicaps. Now Royal Delta has done the same, albeit won as a grade two. We move over to Saturday afternoon, Chicago Way, Arlington Park. The Arlington Oaks on tap. Sky Girl, the 2-1 favorite.
They're off, racing in the Arlington Oaks. Frivolous was awkwardly away. Here's Gold Edge, Sky Girl, Shanine Girl from that inside gate. Bold Kitten, Bold Option is next as they enter the first turn. And we drop back then in the field to Frivolous at the first turn. They're being led by Gold Edge. Gold Edge in front by 3/4 of a length. Sky Girl is right at her side as they round the first turn. Shanine Girl has been edged off the rail by Leandro Gonsalves, and Shanine Girl is third as they settle into stride and the quarter in 24 4/5 seconds. My Option, Frivolous, and Bold Kitten has dropped back to last, now on the back of the track. In front, it's Gold Edge. Gold Edge in front, but Corey Lannery has Sky Girl right on top of the action, and Shanine Girl is a tracking third. Frivolous fourth and toward the rail, and Frivolous is right at the heels of the pace and held up there. Frivolous in the green cap is kept in by Shanine Girl. They're very well grouped with under 5 furlongs to go. My Option is lying in fifth and only 4 from the front, and Bold Kitten trails. A half dozen lengths from joint leaders to last. They leave a half mile pole behind. Four furlongs in 49 3/5 seconds. Sky Girl has nosed in front of Gold Edge. It's Sky Girl and Gold Edge. They are in step. Now this is 3 furlongs out. Shanine Girl right there poised to strike now. My Option comes up wide. Frivolous is still held up. And at the inside is Bold Kitten even taking closer order. A compact polytrack pack as they come past the quarter pole to the top of the stretch. 3/4 in 1:15 flat. They turn for home. My Option has swept in front. Sky Girl matching strides now with My Option, and these two tooth and nail for the final furlong. Frivolous has been switched out, then Gold Edge past the 16th. My Option comes. Frivolous charging on the outside. Sky Girl's third. My Option and Frivolous. My Option prevails over Frivolous, and a driving finish to the Arlington Oaks. Sky Girl finished third.
My Option with Eddie Perez, third stakes score, first one in open company. You saw Frivolous, the longest shot on the board, had a very crowded spot on the turn, unable to get out. She tried to run down My Option in the stretch to no avail. My Option returns $7 even. Frivolous does finish second. Sky Girl, first time stakes, checks in third as the 2-1 favorite. Gonna go up to Woodbine, ladies and gentlemen. Wednesday, we had the Bold Venture Stakes. Essence Hitman, 4-5.
They're off in the Bold Venture Stakes, and Essence Hitman bounced out of there. Paso Doble on the outside, second, and Dimension Flash's early speed at the rail. Bear Tough Tiger is between runners. Then we come back to the last two, outside Consolidator Joe into the inside court of the realm. Essence Hitman up the backstretch. Jesse Campbell trying to harness some of that speed. 3/4 of a length to Bear Tough Tiger in a quick opening quarter mile of 22-1. Essence Hitman will play Catch Me If You Can. Bear Tough Tiger is in second position, down to the inside Dimension third. The New Providence winner, Paso Doble's back fourth and 3 lengths off the lead. Then we have Consolidator Joe, Court of the Realm, Essence Hitman, blasted a half in an eye-popping 44 flat. And it's Essence Hitman at the top of the stretch in the Bold Venture. 3/16 of a mile to go. Dimension angles off the rail. On the far outside is Paso Doble, Essence Hitman, Jesse Campbell pulling out all the stops to try to get the champion home, last 16th of a mile, and it's Essence Hitman and Jesse Campbell to win the Bold Venture for the second year in a row. Dimension at 25-1, finish second, Paso Doble third, and Consolidator Joe was fourth.
Essence Hitman under Jesse Campbell goes to the front, wins back-to-back Bold Ventures. Last year at 9-5, this year at 4-5, returns $3.90. Dimension finishes second. Paso Doble finishes third in this year's Bold Venture. Saturday afternoon, we have the fillies on board. The Ontario Matron Stakes, 4-5 in here. Sisterly Love.
They're off in the Ontario Matron Stakes. Welcome Dance broke well from that outside stall. Logan's Peak to the inside, and now Sisterly Love comes on in the pink to take over the lead for Eureka Rosa da Silva in the run to that first turn. And it's Sisterly Love to dictate the early pace. Yellow Boat out of trouble on the outside in second position, and Logan's Peak is gathered back in third. Welcome Dance in fourth position. Leali Dubai is fifth. Then Eagle Hall and Pure Blue Sky. 24 flat for the opening 2 furlongs. The pace being set by the Trillium winner, Sisterly Love. She leads to the 5/8 pole, 3/4 of a length to Yellow Boat. Welcome Dance on the outside in third position. Logan's Peak drafts in behind horses fourth. Leali Dubai fifth and 3.5 lengths off the lead. Then Pure Blue Sky, Eagle Hall, 48 1/tick for the opening half mile. And they head toward the far turn. Sisterly Love trying to make every pull a winning one. Welcome Dance inches up, and Yellow Boat comes out for clear running at the midpoint of the turn. But it's still Sisterly Love who moves well. De Silva hasn't moved a muscle on this mare as they come to the quarter pole. Yellow Boat's being niggled on, as is Welcome Dance. And Sister We Love cruises to the 3/16th pole under a hand ride, is set down now by Rosa da Silva, and the whip is out, and Sister We Love has kicked away by three. Eagle Hall has come from last, is going to take a crack over the last 16th of a mile, and it's Sister We Love. An outstanding performance, wire to wire in the Ontario Matron over Eagle Hall and Pure Blue Sky with Logan's Peak fourth.
And Sisterly Love, who comes off of an 8-length victory in the Trillium Stakes, as the Ontario Matron goes to the front, never headed, now 2 for 2 with Enrique Rosa da Silva in the saddle. This time she returns $3.90. Eagle Hall finishes second and the second longest shot on the board. Pure Blue Sky checks in third in the Ontario Matron. Sunday afternoon at Woodbine, we get to the turf for the Nijinsky Stakes, the 2-1 favorite, Grand Arch.
They're off in the Nijinsky Stakes. And Valentino Beauty broke on top. Riding the river comes on now to the inside. Hampstead Heath is right there and toward the rail. Grand Arch and Arctic Fern. And Grand Arch pokes ahead in front. Arctic Fern is at the rail and comes on to challenge Grand Arch in the early going. Valentino Beauty in hand in third position. So Long George's fourth and riding the river. Mid-pack fifth and four lengths off the lead. Pender Harbor just to the outside of riding the river. Then Ho Tep and Hampstead Heath, Classic Bryson Pool Play as they run toward the far turn. Arctic Fern now leads at a half a length. Grand Arch and Contreras in a perfect stalking position in second. Valentino Beauty just off that front two and third. Then we have So Long George in fourth and riding the river fifth, 47-3 for the opening half mile. They're 4 furlongs out in the Jijinski. Arctic Fern on the inside by a neck. Grand Arch, what a perfect trip for Grand Arch. Valentino Beauty inches ever closer. So Long George to the inside, third, riding the river out of trouble, fourth, and just 3.5 lengths off the lead. Then we have Hampstead Heath, and they turn for home, and Grand Arch comes on at the quarter pole to take the lead. And it's Grand Arch put to pressure by Luis Contreras. Prado sets down Valentino Beauty, and here comes the King Edward winner riding the river on the far outside. Up the rail, So Long George, a furious finish. So Long George has taken the lead on the outside. Hampstead Heath, they're coming down to the wire. So Long George at 10-1 to win the Nijinsky. Hampstead Heath was second with Grand Arch third and Classic Bryce fourth.
So Long George with Emma Jane Wilson scores the 10-1 upset victory, returning $23.60. Another long shot at better than 20-1. Hampstead Heath finishes second. Grand Arch, first time stakes, the 2-1 favorite, finishes third in the Nijinsky. We're going to take a quick break. When we come back, opening day from Del Mar.
Listen to what people are saying about the Clubhouse Racebook.
I've been coming here for well over 30 years to the OTB, and I think this is an outstanding facility. Probably comparable to something you'd see in Vegas. They have the big screens there, and then they have the auxiliary screens for, you know, watching all the tracks. And the primary tracks of the day, they'll switch to the big screens, which is ideal for most of us race guys. We like to see the big races on the big screen. Well done.
And there's no better place to watch all the racing action than right here on OTB TV. Each morning, the Handicappers Report brings you selections and analysis from our professional handicappers. Then stick around as the biggest names in racing join us live from the backstretch. The top trainers, jockeys, and racing personalities all share their unique insights and observations. For more than 20 years, there's been just one place to turn for unparalleled coverage of the Saratoga Racing Meet, Capital OTB and OTB TV.
Wednesday was opening day at Del Mar, ladies and gentlemen. The traditional opening day feature, the Oceanside in split divisions, as often can be the case in the first division. Undrafted, the 9-5 choice.
And away they go. Examine bobbled a little at the start. Quickest into stride is Man Nando. Jovino came out smoothly along the inside, undrafted right there, and Unfettered on the outside. Unfettered goes up second. They've been followed by Freak and Rocket, now settle fourth. Jovino's back in fifth. They've been followed by Examine, who's now six lengths off these leaders. One Firm Cat on the outside of that. They've been followed by Greedy Awesome. In behind Greedy Awesome on the fence, and being eased here is Tebow's Big Play. Tebow's Big Play eased on the turn. They move on to the backstretch, and Menando, sitting at strong pace on front, gets pressure from Unfettered. Two lengths further back comes Examine and Rock on the inside. On the far side, Freak and Rocket is right there. Alongside of that is Undrafted, only two lengths off these leaders. Jovino, One Firm Cat in behind that. Then a big gap of five back to Greeley Awesome and On the Fence. Into the turn they go in the Asian side. Menando is still the leader, being chased by Unfettered, who's under pressure. Now here comes Undrafted at the rail. And Undrafted now just looking for somewhere to go. Meanwhile, Freak and Rocket got first run. And Freak and Rocket on the outside. Undrafted needs somewhere to run. Jovino's in with a shot behind that. At the top of the lane, and Freak and Rocket in the Black Cat takes the lead. Let's see, Undrafted still trying to find a way through. Jovino running a huge one. Unfettered tries to battle back. Out of nowhere, Greeley Awesome. Greeley Awesome coming like a rocket on the outside. Jovino. Jovino holding Greeley Awesome. Jovino. Jovino won a thriller. Jovino won the Oceanside. Greeley Awesome second. Freaking Rocket third. And Undrafted finish fourth.
Jovino, second start in 2013, moves to 9-3-for-5 lifetime. Rafael Bejarano's aboard the second choice in the wagering for Carla Gaines. They win the first division of the Oceanside, returning $7.80. Greeley Awesome checks in second, with Freakin' Rocket third choice in the wagering, finishing third. The favorite, Undrafted, you saw him under Joel Rosario, who had a very good opening day at Del Mar, but had some traffic trouble with Undrafted, finishes fourth as the 9-5 favorite. Later on in the afternoon, the second division of the Oceanside Stakes, the 2-1 favorite, Den's Legacy.
And away they go. All appear to come out well. In the center, we have Show Some Magic showing some speed up alongside Olympic Blue. Rosengold going to have to drop in, caught a little wide. Sea Sage in the red is right there as well. And Gabriel Charles on the inside of Saint Prado. And racing alongside of them comes Rising Legend. Into the turn they go. Now an Olympic Blue sets just a steady pace. Rosengold right there second. Show Some Magic scrapes the paint in third, and Sea Sage Red Cap. On the far side we have Jolito. Jolito's in fifth, four off the leaders. In behind that we have Den's Legacy racing between them. Saint Prado is down at the rail. Rising Legend second last, seven off these leaders. And last of all now is Gabriel Charles. They head to the half-mile pole, and it's now Rosengold kicked on. And Rosengold's opened up. Rosengold goes clear, 2.5. Olympic Blue in second, Sea Sage third, then So Some Magic. Den's Legacy, Jolito has to go 3 wide, is now 5 off that lead, who's kicking away for home. Behind that comes Rising Legend, along the inside is Saint Prado, and still last is Gabriel Charles. Coming to the top of the lane, and Rosengold telling them, come and catch me to win this one. It's Rosengold kicking on for home. Olympic Blue is in second, Sea Sage, Jolito, Rising Legend on the outside. They come for home now, and Rosengold goes on just in front, Olympic Blue. Now here comes Rising Legend on the outside. Rising Legend finishing stoutly on the outside, and Gabriel Charles flying. Rising Legend, Gabriel Charles, Rising Legend, Gabriel Charles flying late. And then there'll be a photo between Olympic Blue and Rosengold for third.
You wanted to be well back early to get the exacta in here. Rising Legend making the second start in the United States, the first time since running on November 24th in the Generous Stakes to a runner-up position. Scores a victory in the Oceanside for John Sadler. They return $17.60. Gabriel Charles finishes second. And the longest shot on the board at nearly 50-1, Olympic Blue finishes third. Den's Legacy making the first start on the turf since winning the Generous Stakes back in November, finishes sixth as the 2-1 favorite. Moving on to Saturday afternoon, we're going to start on the turf for the Phillies and Mares. the Ocenitis Stakes, the 7-5 favorite, Unusual Hottie.
And away they go. Dancing to the Stars begins well from the inside. Top Kisser is right there as well. Between them comes Unusual Hottie. On the outside, we have A Time to Love going up to join them as well. They followed by Maker or Breaker, A Jealous Woman taken back today to be fifth. Only four off them. No speed on early on. Back to closing range. Then comes Appealing. In behind that is I Dazzle and Long Face as last. They head to the three-quarter pole now, and Top Kisser got an easy lead. Ears Prick just taking them along comfortably. Top Kisser, an easy lead. Racing along in second, A Time to Love. At the rail comes Dancing to the Stars. Between horses, Unusual Hottie. Maker or Breaker on the far side. Three lengths covers five. A Jealous Woman is in the gold colors, followed by Closing Range. In behind that comes Appealing, who's now six lengths off the leaders. Then comes I Dazzle and Long Face. Seven would cover the lot. A half mile left to go, and Top Kisser still shows the way. Top Kisser in front, now getting some pressure though by A Time to Love. Those two go into the turn in front, then Maker or Breaker. Dancing to the Stars right there at the rail. Between horses, Unusual Hottie, and Unusual Hottie now coming to tackle between them. In behind that, A Jealous Woman closing range. They turn it into a sprint for home now. Top Kisser along the inside. Outside of that, A Time to Love. A Time to Love takes the lead from Top Kisser. Down the center, Unusual Hottie. And now Unusual Hottie's unleashing her run and coming with a big run. Dancing to the Stars, flying late as well, and then closing range. But it's Unusual Hottie on the outside, closing range, closing range, closing range. Tags Unusual Hottie at the wire. I Dazzle came out the clouds to snatch her.
And what an incredible final 16th of a mile by Closing Range. First time aboard for Corey Nakatani, for Phil Oliver. They win the Ocenitis Stakes, returning $35.40. Unusual Hottie, who was going for four in a row, finishes second as a 7-5 favorite, and also well back. A matter of fact, last at the eighth pole, I Dazzle finishes third. Also on Saturday afternoon, we had Grade 1 action from Del Mar, 9 furlongs on the turf. This is the Eddie Reed Geronimo, 5-2.
In this time. And away they go in the Grade 1, Eddie Reed. Slim Shady has ridden along for the lead from the outside. Fed Biz very quick along the rail. Fly Lexus Fly goes up between those two. The pace very good for this distance. In behind that, Cogito. Down along the inside is Baraccio. There's only four lengths covering all those runners. Then three and a half back to Midi and So Fast. Vagabond Shoes on the outside and Geronimo's last, a good 12 off the leaders. Into the turn they go, and Fed Biz along the inside and Slim Shady. They keeping the pressure on one another. They go a fast pace. They've opened up almost five. Fly Lexus Fly is back in the third spot. Cogito on the far side in fourth. At the rail, Baracci's traveling well enough, six off the leaders. Then a big gap of four and a half lengths back to Midi. Vagabond Shoes on the far side. Geronimo is at the back, was So Fast. Still strung out over a lot of ground. They head to the half-mile pole. Fed Biz on the inside and Slim Shady. They stride for stride. They clear by almost four. Fly Lexus Fly is in third. Cogito on the far side. Baracci down at the rail. Now six off that leader. Four back to Vagabond Shoes. Geronimo still a good 11 off them. Then Midi and So Fast. They come into the top of the lane now in the Eddie Reed. Along the inside, it's Fed Biz. Slim Shady right there. Now here comes Fly Lexus Fly. And Fly Lexus Fly coming to look for the lead on the outside. Baracci now comes out too, and Baracci comes to chase them home. Vagabond Shoes and Geronimo joins the fray late, suddenly wide open. Here's Geronimo down the center of the track, getting a perfect hand ride. So Fast has come out of nowhere too, but Geronimo absolutely perfectly ridden by Rafael Bejarano. And Geronimo wins the Erie Reed. Vagabond Shoes was second. Fly Lexus Fly holds on to third.
And under Rafael Bejarano, last early, which seems to be the theme for the Del Mar Turf Course early in their meet. The favorite gets up to score at $7.80. And then a couple of long shots in here, ladies and gentlemen. Vagabond Shoes, 23-1, finishes second. Fly Lexus Fly finishes third as the longest shot on the board, 37-1. The $2 trifecta with the favorite on top comes back better than $2,500 in Saturday's Grade 1, Eddie Reed. We'll take a quick break. When we come back, more action from Del Mar and a visit to Finger Lakes.
Face it, some mobile websites are just too much. Too much clutter. Too much to navigate through. Next time, log on to CapitalOTV.com. There you'll find everything you need. Clear, concise, easy to navigate. Check your account, wager, watch replays, get results. All the information you want with none of the clutter. CapitalOTV.com mobile, try it now.
Continue with our stakes action from Del Mar. A couple to bring you from Saturday afternoon, staying on the turf, the California Dreamin' Summer Hit. First time Del Mar, 9-5.
And away they go. Rock Me Baby bounces away fast, but so does Summer Hit, and Summer Hit will get the lead. Along the inside, Lucky Primo now sneaking through at the rail, and Lucky Primo picks up the running. Campari is right there at joint third, followed by Star Spangled Heat. Then it is the grey Hebe Fire and Ice. Come back to Holiday Road, who's 8 lengths off the leaders. Risky Reward second last, and Soul Candy trails. They head towards the three-quarter pole, and Lucky Primo just setting a sensible pace here. Ears pricked, not in a big hurry, leads it by one length. Summer Hit is quite content to just sit there in second. Campari's in third. Back in fourth is Rock Me Baby, only 3 lengths off the leaders. Star Spangled Heat at the rail. Up alongside come Hebe Fire and Ice the Grey. They followed by Holiday Road, who's comfortable, only 5 off the leaders. 2.5 more to Risky Reward, and Soul Candy is still last. So there's no change in the order. They've just run past the half-mile pole. Lucky Primo continues to show the way. The favorite Summer Hit right there is second. On the far side, Rock Me Baby. Campari tucked in at the rail, waiting his time. In behind that, Hebe Fire and Ice. They quickening now. Then comes Holiday Road, Star Spangled Heat, and Risky Reward. Top of the lane now, and Lucky Primo hanging on to the lead. Up alongside comes Summer Hit. And Summer Hit now comes looking for the lead. Here is Rock Me Baby on the outside with a big run. Rock Me Baby spurted right on by the grey Hebe Fire and Ice, running on late with Holiday Road too. Homeward bound, Hebe Fire and Ice. Hebe Fire and Ice, Rock Me Baby. Hebe Fire and Ice, Hebe Fire and Ice. Up to win it ahead to Rock Me Baby. Star Spangled Heat ran on for third.
Hebe Fire and Ice back early. First on the line, returning $10.80 for John Sadler. That is now 3 in a row. Lifetime 3-for-3 with Victor Espinosa. 4-for-5 lifetime on the turf. Rock Me Baby finishes second. Star Spangled Heat checks in third. Summer Hit finishes sixth as the 9-to-5 favorite. 3-year-old fillies kick off their series at Del Mar in the San Clemente. The 8-to-5 favorite, Itapa.
And away they go. Miss Empire broke a little awkwardly. From the inside, Unusual Ways away well. Lil Born Eliza is right there too. They joined by Judy in Disguise. Itapa has got a good spot right behind the leading group and Wishing Gate in the gold cap. Charlie M is on the outside, 4 off the leaders. They're getting a good pace out here. Then we come back to Disco Dasco. Miss Empire's back second last, gives them 8 length start. And last of all is Kiriaki. They head to the three-quarter pole, an Unusual Way out here, leads it by a length. In second is Lil Born Eliza. Behind that is Itapa, traveling comfortably in third. Up alongside comes Judy in Disguise, and they are then being followed by Wishing Gate, who's only 4 lengths off these leaders. Alongside is Charlie M, and they have been followed by Disco Dasco, who's pretty keen to go on. Disco Dasco now 7 off them, then Miss Empire and Kariaki. They set off into the far turn, and Unusual Way shows the way by a length. In the second spot is Lil Born Eliza. On the far side, Itapa now comes to tackle. Itapa moving in, two off these leaders. Behind that, Wishing Gate, and Wishing Gate going well too, needs somewhere to run at the rail, comes to take them on. Behind that, Judy in Disguise. At the top of the lane, Unusual Ways made a dash for home. Unusual Way, but here comes Wishing Gate, and Wishing Gate is flying up. Itapa just not doing enough. It is Wishing Gate striking the front with a 16th to go. And Wishing Gate and Gary Stevens are going to take the San Clemente. Wishing Gate, stylish, wins it by two. Unusual Way second. Itapa was third. And Charlie M finished fourth.
Wishing Gate with Gary Stevens for Tom Proctor and Glen Hill Farm. Every time you see those silks with Gary Stevens, you probably flash back to One Dreamer winning the 94 distaff, but this afternoon, $12 even to win the Grade 2 San Clemente Handicap. Unusual Way finishes second. Itapa, first time turf as the 8-5 favorite, finishes third. You see the 133.580.04 seconds off the stakes record. A brilliant, brilliant performance by Wishing Gate. Couple stakes races to bring you from Saturday afternoon at Finger Lakes. Unfortunately, inclement weather got us a sloppy sealed racetrack. Up first, the Arctic Queen, 7-5, Lady on the Run.
We're ready for the Arctic Queen. And there they go in the 14th running of the Arctic Queen Handicap. Sing Dixie Sing, Princess Phoebe, Lady Vi, and Sweetheart Toddie. These are the four quickly into stride. In the fifth position runs Smitten by Gold with Capella Dancer and Saltamonte. Sentimental Lass goes with them. Towards the tail is Floating Alone and Lady on the Run. Sing Dixie Sing is the speed of the field, better than a length and a half to Princess Phoebe. Lady Vi sharing third with Sweetheart Toddie, more than three lengths off the lead. Break of at least four to Smitten by Gold, better than two, back to Saltamonte. Sentimental Lass is midfield. And she races in front of Capella Dancer. It's 3.5 to Floating Alone. Another 2.5 to Lady on the Run, who has lots of work to do. Quick opening quarter of 21-4 established by Sing Dixie Sing. She will enter the lane with the lead. Princess Phoebe's losing ground from second. I'm going to Lady Vi and Sweetheart Toddie. Smitten by Gold's trying to close up the rail. Following her, Sentimental Lass with Capella Dancer. Final furlong to travel in the Arctic Queen. And Sing Dixie Sing has the lead. Sweetheart Toddie's trying to come and get her. And here comes Capella Dancer. And Lady on the Run. Sing Dixie Sing. Lady on the Run to the far outside. Sing Dixie Sing will hang on. Lady on the Run was flying. She's in a photo for second with Capella Dancer. And further back with Sweetheart Toddie with Floating Alone and Sentimental Lass.
Sing Dixie Sing goes to the front under John Davila Jr. as the second choice in the wagering. Scores at $5.90, making the stakes debut. Now 2-for-2 with Jason Service after Jason Service claimed this horse for $35,000 on May 23rd from David Jacobson. And last year's winner at 1-2. Is this year's third place finish at 7-5, Lady on the Run. Also on Saturday afternoon at Finger Lakes, contested over a sloppy sealed racetrack, leg two of the Big Apple Triple. This is the 41st running of the New York Derby. Winner of the Mike Lee, Amberjack, 7-5.
And there they go in the 41st running of the New York Derby. Amberjack is showing speed, and he's getting away from the rail. Go get the Basils up close with Smooth Burt, Street Lord, the widest of all. In behind them is West Hills Giant, and Tequila Hero is the current trailer. As they race into the clubhouse turn, Smooth Burt, one from the outside, Street Lord pressing three wide. Amberjack goes with the leader line from the rail. West Hills Giant secures a very nice tracking position. He's in the fourth spot, just under 2.5 for three off the lead. A length in front of Go Get the Basil, and Tequila Heroes at the back. Five lengths covers the six-pack in the New York Derby as they race into the backstretch run. The opening quarter was fairly legit, 23-2. Smooth Bird and Wilfredo Rohina from between runners. Street Lord pressing under John Davila Jr. Amberjack's right there sitting chilly from the rail, and West Hills Giant makes his move four wide in the clear. Go Get the Basil and Tequila Hero are at the tail. 3.5 covers the group, a 47.5. Smooth Burt still calling the shots. West Hills Giant has emerged into second. Amberjack takes over third. Go Get the Basil begins to close in 2.5 off the lead. 3 furlongs from the wire. Tequila Hero needs to go now. 5 lengths off the lead. Street Lord calls it an early day. 112-2 for three quarters. West Hills Giant from between runners, Smooth Burt from the rail. And also there go get the Basil, and Amberjack's trying to re-rally now in the three path. Four of them battle for the top spot in the New York Derby, Smooth Burt, and here's Amberjack. Amberjack comes away with the lead at the eighth pole. Final furlong to travel in the New York Derby. And here's Amberjack, the Mike Lee champion. Now he'll add the New York Derby to his resume. And he just needs one more to sweep the Big Apple Triple. It's Amberjack, an authoritative winner of the New York Derby under Jose Espinoza. Smooth Burt was second. Then West Hills Giant, Go Get the Basil, Tequila Hero, and Street Lord.
And Amberjack, who was actually 6-5, scores the victory by 6.5 lengths under Jose Espinoza. They return $4.50. Amberjack has now won at Aqueduct, Belmont, and Finger Lakes, and hopefully will be coming to Saratoga for the Wednesday, August 21st, Albany Stakes with a $250,000 bonus on the line. Smooth Burt finishes second. West Hill Giant third under Edgar Prado in this year's New York Derby. We'll take a quick break. When we get back, Saratoga 2013.
Listen to what people are saying about the Clubhouse Racebook.
I've been coming here for well over 30 years to the OTB, and I think this is an outstanding facility. Probably comparable to something you'd see in Vegas. They have the big screens there, and then they have the auxiliary screens for, you know, watching all the tracks. And the primary tracks of the day, they'll switch to the big screens, which is ideal for most of us race guys. We like to see the big races on the big screen. Well done.
Here in upstate New York, no one provides bettors with more wagering options than Capital OTB. Our network of branch and easy bet locations stretches from the mid-Hudson Valley all the way to the Canadian border and west to central New York. So whether you need to place a bet, fund your Capital Bets account, or watch the next big race, all the action is just around the corner. A full list of our branch and easy bet locations can be found online at CapitalOTB.com. Capital OTB, the better and most convenient choice for wagering in upstate New York.
Saratoga 2013 graded stakes action got underway with the James Marvin on Friday afternoon, 7 furlong, super speedy, 9-5.
And they're off. Strapping Groom off a beat slowly. Super Speedy and Sage Valley out for that lead. There goes Strapping Groom and Lori's Rocket. Those four across the track early on with Politically Correct. And at the back is the gray Hello Lover. Up the back stretch. Four of them now. And there goes Super Speedy to take charge. Super Speedy moving aggressively to the lead. Lori's Rocket. And on the outside, Strapping Groom, they're second and third. In behind them, Sage Valley is fourth. Behind an opening quarter mile in 22 1/5 seconds into the far turn. It's Super Speedy, Strapping Groom, Lori's Rocket sandwiched between those two. Tracking them at Sage Valley running in fourth. A break of another 6 lengths now back to Politically Correct. And Hello Lover who takes to the outside as they round the far turn. 44-2, a bruising opening half mile here. Strapping Groom and Super Speedy. Lori's Rocket now backs off into third. To the outside goes Sage Valley as the field turns for home. Politically Correct coming up the inside. Hello Lover making a run from the back of the pack down the center of the track. Strapping Groom narrowly. Super Speedy fighting hard. On the outside, Sage Valley and farthest out, Hello Lover. Politically Correct and a little bit tight down to the final 16th. Sage Valley in front, Politically Correct. They're coming down to the line, and it is Sage Valley to win it. 3/4 length, Politically Correct was second. Hello Lover was third. Super Speedy was fourth.
And in the middle of the racetrack, after a very fast early pace, it's Sage Valley. First time Cornelio Velasquez, the third choice in the wagering, returns $8.90. Had a four-race winning streak snapped in the True North, but bounces right back in the third start of the year. Politically Correct dives down to the inside to finish second. Hello Lover finishes third. Super Speedy, the 9-5 favorite, finishes off the board in the James Marvin. The traditional opening day feature at Saratoga, two-year-old fillies in the Schuylerville, and after off of a very impressive debut, Bonon, very late action, goes off as the 6-5 favorite.
They're in the gate. And they're off.
off. Brazen Persuasion racing to the front. And yes, Liz is right there up on the outside. And Elena Strikes comes on through between horses to be third. Bana up close and fourth on the outside. Jones and Jerry for Jones and on the inside. And then Silver Valley in a break of another four back to True Blue Nation as they race for the far turn. Brazen Persuasion knocking heads here with Yes, Liz. Those two into the far turn together. Bana to the attack. There goes Bana up and after the lead. 21-3 was the opening quarter mile. Elena Strikes in behind the leaders, running in fourth. And then it's a big break back to the rest of them. Silver Valley, Jones and for Jerry. And the last of all, True Blue Nation, as they come to the top of the stretch. Bana rolls up on the outside. Yes, Liz battles on in between horses. Brazen Persuasion fights on at the rail. And Elena Strikes puts in her bid now with one furlong to go. Brazen Persuasion is a stubborn filly here. Brazen Persuasion holding on to the lead. Bana comes at her again with another 100 yards to go. Brazen Persuasion, Bana, it's going to be very close, and it's going to be a photo finish. Brazen Persuasion and Bana hit the line together. Elena Strikes and Yes, Liz.
A dead heat, ladies and gentlemen, to kick off opening day, or to wrap up opening day, as were Brazen Persuasion, who was the favorite in much of the wagering in the Schuylerville, goes off as the second choice, puts in a fantastic effort under Rosen the Pravnik on the pace down inside, scintillating fractions up front, looked beat multiple times in the lane, but does hold on to dead heat with the favorite Bonon. Brazen Persuasion returns $2.80. Bonon returns $2.40. Alana Strikes for Todd Pletcher finishes third in the Schuylerville. You see the final running time of 1:12.12. I think that's a Shadows time 10 years ago. Saturday afternoon, a couple of stakes races to bring you for the Distaffers. Up first, three-year-olds and up fillies and mares for the first time. Run at a mile and eighth for the first time. Not run in the month of May. For the first time, run at Saratoga. The Shuvie, 1-2, Authenticity.
Of the Shuvie, and they are off. Flash American Authenticity from our far outside post. Sealand's between them along with Moon Philly. And then toward the back of the pack, Royal Lahaina off last was a Blue Assant, who's on the outside now. So around the clubhouse turn they go. Sea Island is the leader. Authenticity was thought to be the one to be the front runner, is now sitting back in second. And then it's Moon Philly racing along in third position. Flash American on the fence in fourth. And then a Blue Assant settles back in fifth, about five lengths from the lead. Well in reserve in the early stages here. Royal Lahaina trails the field. And it's just a walk. 25-2, a pedestrian opening quarter mile here, set by Sea Island. Authenticity still sitting back in second. And then Moon Philly on the outside third. Flash American is fourth. A Blue Assant still about four and a half from the lead. Down toward the rail, Royal Lahaina comes to an opening there. Sea Island still cruising on the lead, waltzing through an opening half mile in 50 4/5 seconds. And at 1-2, Authenticity right in her hip pocket, second now as they hit the half mile pole. And then it's Moon Philly, Royal Lahaina, Flashy American. Bully Santa has been given her cue here by Rosina Provenick. Nonetheless, is still six lengths from the lead and making no progress at this point, midway on the far turn. Sea Island now set upon by Authenticity. Sea Island the neck, Authenticity right there. Moon Philly putting in her run now. Flashy American, Royal Lahaina, Ebluie Sant is last as the field turns for home. Sea Island, Authenticity on even terms. And now Johnny Velasquez says go with Authenticity, but Flashy American is coming up the rail. Authenticity in front, Flashy American and Sea Island and Moon Philly coming down to the finish. It is Authenticity as they come down to the line. Authenticity took it, 3/4 of a length. Flashy American was second, Sea Island third, Moon Philly fourth.
Yes, the teletimer was correct, ladies and gentlemen, and try to remember these 25-2, 50-4, 115 flat fractions when we look at the three-year-old fillies going the same distance about 30 minutes later. But Authenticity sits off Sea Island's early lead under John Velasquez. They return $3 even. Flashy American finishes second. Sea Island, the early pace setter, fades to finish third. Ublesant, who was the second choice in the wagering, unruly in the gate. really had an awful, awful experience in the Shuvi. She doesn't pick up her feet. She runs last. The first six furlongs in the Shuvi, 115.03. The final three furlongs, 37.3, might remind you of turf racing. 30 minutes later, three-year-old fillies, the Grade 1 Coaching Club American Oaks, unlimited budget, exiting the Belmont 6-5.
And they're off. Little awkward beginning there for unlimited budget. So over at the rail, it's My Happy Face. Right next to her is Cue the Moon as they race for the turn. Marathon Lady up close. Princess of Silmar now fourth and on the outside. And down toward the rail is unlimited budget. Unlimited budget gaining ground while saving ground around the first turn. And in front is It's My Happy Face. Off there by two lengths, Cue the Moon continues on while running in second. Marathon Lady there on the outside. Unlimited budget on the fence, fourth, 2.5 lengths from the lead, and Princess of Silmar is drafting in behind them. Princess of Silmar is only 4 lengths away from the tepid pace here of 24-4 for the opening quarter mile, set by My Happy Face. So the pace is slow, the pack is tight, the battle is yet to begin here as My Happy Face continues on an uncontested lead. Marathon Lady on the outside, unlimited budget on the rail. In between those two is Cue the Moon. Princess of Silmar still laying off the leaders about 5 lengths from the front now as they move past the half-mile pole. They run a half-mile in 48.45 seconds. So around the far turn, My Happy Face has been loose on an uncontested lead here with Easy Fractions. Marathon Lady to the attack at the midway point on the far turn. And there goes Princess of Silmar with a sweeping move on the far outside. And here she comes now. Cue the Moon and unlimited budget has dropped back to last and is dropping farther behind as they turn for home. Princess of Silmar coming with a four-wide sweep far outside. My Happy Face is second as they come to the final furlong. Cue the Moon and Marathon Lady, unlimited budget, not doing well at all today. They're in the final furlong, and it is Princess of Silmar. The Kentucky Oaks winner is going to win the coaching club American Oaks, and did it well. She was a 5.5 length winner over My Happy Face and Marathon Lady.
Princess of Silmar, who was last early behind Fractions of 24-3, 44-4, 112-4. In the old days, we might have said that the pace in the Coaching Club American Oaks was 10 lengths faster to the 6-furlong mark than it was with the older filly mares. Princess of Silmar making the first start since her very nice score in the Kentucky Oaks. Add the Coaching Club American Oaks to her resume. Second choice in the wagering as she wins off by six, returns $6.30. The pace setter, My Happy Face, finishes second. Marathon Lady finishes third. Unlimited Budget finishes last at 6-5. On Sunday afternoon, we had two-year-olds in the Sanford Stakes. 9-5, two-time stakes winner, Debt Ceiling.
And they're off. And it's Hollywood Talent and Wired Brian going out for the early lead. Debt Ceiling came away racing in third. Jake's Magic Hat alongside is fourth. Then comes All in Blue in fifth. And it's almost 5 lengths back to Southern Blessing, who trails the field in sixth up the backstretch. Wired Brian the Gray has the lead by a half length. Hollywood Talent now draws right alongside. Hollywood Talent on the outside and Wired Brian. Now Hollywood Talent takes the lead and Wired Brian is racing in second. All in Blue has moved up to third. Jake's Magic Hat back running in fourth. Debt Ceiling is fifth and the trailer is Southern Blessing and the two-year-old colts come for the quarter pole. Hollywood Talent, Wired Brian down on the inside. It is Hollywood Talent, Wired Brian. Here's All in Blue looking to go outside. Now has to switch to inside, but it's Wired Brian down at the rail with the lead. Then Hollywood Talent and All in Blue. Southern Blessing up to fourth in Jake's Magic Hat. Debt Ceiling is the trailer. Wired Brian draws away now, and it's going to be Wired Brian to take the Sanford. Southern Blessing second, then Hollywood Talent, All in Blue, Jake's Magic Hat, and Debt Ceiling.
Wired Brian, fifth choice in the wagering. The exacta, ladies and gentlemen, the fifth choice and the longest shot on the board. But Wired Brian wires this field, ostensibly winning off by better than 5 lengths as Michael Dillinger, the old Todd Pletcher assistant as a young man, steps into Stakes Company for the first time. He is one for one. Well, Michael, I guess it's all down here statistically from here, but Wired Byron, very, very impressive returns, $16.40. The exacta comes back $254 as the 23-1 shot. Southern Blessing finishes second. Hollywood Talent third. Debt Ceiling, 3 for 3 with two stakes coming in, finishes last as the 9-5 favorite in the Sanford. And with the bonus, the $100,000 bonus, Wired Brian scores his purse $220,000 in Sunday Sanford. That wraps up this week's edition of Horses and Courses. Ladies and gentlemen, we are well underway at Del Mar and Saratoga. We invite you to join us next time as we review the stakes racing from around the country.